We've won some really nice contracts with the state of North Carolina related to AFFF firefighting foam, which is being eliminated across the United States because, again, it's very toxic to humans and the environment. And we also just recently signed an agreement with a very established RCRA permitted TSDF organization to build our first waste destruction site.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Chris Gannon. He is the CEO of 374Water. And Chris, it's great to see you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks so much for having us here, Steve. Great to see you.
Yeah, excited to learn a bit more about what you're doing, your technology. You're working on making the planet a better place, that's for sure. So maybe just give us a little synopsis of the company.
Yeah, great. Well, thanks so much again. So 374Water has a is an industrial technology company that has an incredible technology called AirSCWO. And that technology is designed to destroy hazardous and non-hazardous organic wastes, and in the process, produce safe, dischargeable water, some mineral effluent, some vent gas, which is also safe, and then an immense amount of heat energy. We are able to destroy those organic wastes really better than anyone. And we're targeting focused on disrupting the roughly $450 billion global municipal, federal, and industrial markets where they're seeking solutions to this very specific need.
Yeah, there are a lot of spots all around, North America, but specifically you're in the US, all around the US that would utilize this type of technology, whether you're a government agency, municipal. I mean, I think you would try to target them all, right?
That's right, absolutely. And each one has different needs,
Yeah.
but all of them are seeking a very significant solution to addressing basically the other solutions that are out there just are totally insufficient. And so they're very, very actively looking for a better approach to completely destroy or eliminate the waste so it doesn't exist anymore. And that's what our technology does.
When I was researching your company, I noticed that you talk a lot about the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency and how they're looking at getting rid of PFAS. And maybe you could explain that what that is and how your technology really could be a benefit to that.
Oh, for sure, for sure. So PFAS are basically thousands of synthetic chemicals that have been developed and utilized across industries and are found in all sorts of everyday products that we interact with on a daily basis. And those synthetic chemicals are termed forever chemicals because they don't break down naturally in the environment. And they're very toxic to humans, the environment, and so forth. And so there's, again, thousands of these chemicals. They're toxic. They don't break down naturally. And we have a means to do that. So when we think about those synthetic chemicals, there are short and what's called long chain PFAS forever chemicals. Some other technologies out there are able to break down some of that. Ours can eradicate it completely, so it doesn't exist anymore.
Wow. I know you've had some big wins recently with the company. Talk about what you've seen this year so far and really what's ahead.
Yeah, so we're interestingly enough, we are pivoting our business quite significantly to being a very much a service model. So historically, when I joined the business, it was pretty much focused on capital sale of technology. Well, the reality is that the markets, those markets we talked about, the municipal, federal, industrial markets, all are looking for services, destruction services. And so that's what we are pursuing aggressively now. We've won some really nice contracts with the state of North Carolina related to AFFF firefighting foam, which is being eliminated across the United States because, again, it's very toxic to humans and the environment. And we also just recently signed an agreement with a very established RCRA permitted TSDF organization to build our first waste destruction site.
Wow. It sounds exciting. It's when you sort of come to work every day, I would imagine that you never know what you're going to expect because everyone has such unique things. And I guess that's what your message is your process and your technology is really agnostic for many different things.
That's exactly right. And we focused on expanding the technical capabilities of our technology over the last, 6 to 10 months for that specific reason. So we started out as an organization very focused just on the elimination of biosolids at wastewater treatment facilities all across the country. Well, that's one market that we are aggressively going after, and we see huge opportunities. We're at the City of Orlando's water reclamation facility down in Florida. We're about to move our technology or install our technology in Orange County, at Orange County Sanitation out in California. And so big market there, 16,000 wastewater treatment facilities. But there are just so much other. The federal government is, beating down our door, asking us to start to provide services to them. So the future is very bright for our organization.
Absolutely. Chris, thanks so much. Great to catch up with you and what the company is doing. It's important work, I know, and we really appreciate your time to share the story with us.
Yeah, thanks so much, Steve. Really great to see you and have a great day.
Yeah, you as well. There's Chris Gannon, the CEO of 374 Water.